Good morning to one and all. With the blessings of Goddess Vasavamba, it gives me a great pleasure to welcome you all to the national webinar organized by Mathematics Department, Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women. I am happy to welcome our resource person, Dr. P. Venkata Subbareddy, Assistant Professor, Department of Computer Science and Engineering, National Institute of Technology, Warangal, India. I extend a very warm welcome to all the participants from various colleges. A brief introduction of the speaker. Dr. P. Venkata Subbareddy completed his doctorate in Computer Science and Engineering in 2013 at National Institute of Technology, Trichinopoly. His area of specialization, algorithms and graph theory. He has more than 10 years of experience in teaching. He has published many papers in conference, national and international journals. He was a resource person in national conference, national workshop and faculty development program and delivered lectures in graph theory and its applications, design and analysis of algorithms, discrete mathematics, theory of computation, programming in C and data structures. Once again, we welcome you, sir. Now the session over to you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much, madam. First of all, I would like to thank the management of Sri Kanyaka Parameshwari Arts and Science College for Women and HOD madam and Sudha madam, who has been contacting me regarding this workshop. Thank you, madam. Thank you once again. So now title of our webinar is Recurrence Relations and Analysis of Algorithms. So this analysis of algorithm, because majority of you are from mathematics background, I learned that you had one course, say like a programming course in our curriculum. So some of you must be teaching that course. And if there are any student participants, definitely you must have gone through that, you must have completed that course. So it will be a bit easier for you to follow. Now, so in this, first we will see what is this is the outline of my presentation. First we will see what is a computational problem and what is the model we use to solve that problem. What does order of growth mean? What are different asymptotic notations? How to analyze non-recursive algorithms? And what is recurrence relation? What are some recurrence relations we encounter in analyzing non-recursive algorithms? And what summary and references? So first we start with what is a problem? So in computer science or in engineering, whenever we say problem, what does it mean? What does it mean? So that means we want to solve a problem. We want to solve a problem where some computation is involved in it, and we want some computing device like a computer to solve it for us. So that type of problems only we are talking about. So there is some computation involved in it, and we want some computing device to solve it for us. That type of problems only we are talking about. We are not talking about problems, for example, how to become rich in 2 years. Are we going to talk about this type of problems? No. Why? Because any computing device, it is not going to give us any solution for this kind of problems. Or how to remain happy forever throughout our life. Is any computing device going to give solution for this problem? No, we are not actually talking about these kinds of problems. We are actually talking about problems where some computer. So what are simple examples for problems? Given a positive integer, determining whether that integer is prime or not. So that is one simple problem. So here there are some steps. If you follow that sequence of steps, then we might get answer. We will be able to decide whether it is a prime number or not. Similarly, find a non-trivial prime factor of that n. Okay, if it is even number, automatically 2 is a prime factor, no? So other than that, any other non-trivial prime factor of that integer n. Or similarly, if you are given a graph, find what is maximum independent set of that graph. These are all examples. Similarly, searching problem. These are all examples for computational problems. Computational problems. Now, so what is a sorting problem? Any problem we need to formally define. We need to formally define. That means we need to clearly say what is input, what is output to that problem. What is input in case of sorting problem? So input is a sequence of n numbers. That numbers we are labeling it as, say, a1, a2, and so on, an. A1 is first number, a2 is second number, and so on, an is second last nth number. Now, what is output? What is output here? A permutation or reordering of these n elements, say a1 dash, a2 dash, and so on, an dash of the input sequence, such that a1 dash is less than or equal to a2 dash, which is less than or equal to a3 dash, and so on, less than or equal to an dash. And this is called sorting problem. We are given a sequence. We need to find a permutation of this sequence such that first element is less than or equal to second element, and so on, less than or equal to nth element. Okay. Then this is known as formal way of defining any problem. Okay. Now, what does an instance of problem mean? Instance means what are the specific values we give as input. That becomes instance. For example, if I give 20 in place of A1, 20, A2, 18, A3, 68, A4, 42, A5, 90, and A6, 82. Then that becomes an instance of this sorting problem. Instance of this sorting problem. And what is n value here? What is n value here? So I request the HOD madam and Sudha madam to give access to at least some participants, so that whenever I ask question, no, at least one or two participants respond to my questions.
Okay, sir.
No issues. At least some participants.
Yes, sir. Okay.
So now, what is this? Is an instance of this sorting problem. So what is instance? What is the size of what is n value here? What is n value here? Please respond. What is n value here? What is n value here?
Vasavi, can unmute ma. Vasavi, you can unmute yourself.
What is n value here? So for example, input is sequence of n numbers. Here input is given as 20, 18, 68, 42, 90, 82. So total how many elements are given to us? Total how many elements are given to us?
Six, sir.
Six. So now what is the size of input? What is n value here? What is n value? N is nothing but six. N is six. N is six. That we call it as input size. In case of this sorting problem, how many elements or numbers are given to us? That we call it as size of that instance. Instance here given has six elements. That's why this instance size or input size here is six. In general, input size we denote by n, like whatever is shown in input, whatever is shown here. This is n is input size. Okay. Now, for example, in case of matrix related problem, what is input size? For example, matrix related problem, matrix addition, what is input size?
N cross n, sir.
If it is square matrix, n cross n. Otherwise, number of rows as well as number of columns. That means input size can be one parameter as shown in sorting problem, or it can be more than one parameter. Yes, for example, when we consider matrix related problems, number of rows will be there as well as number of columns also will be there. Number of columns. Then we can say M and N are input size. M and N are input size. In case of graph problem, what is input size? Already I learned that there was a webinar on chemical graph theory also recently. So what is What is input in case of graph? What is that? What is a graph? It contains two sets. No, vertex set as well as edge set. Vertex set and edge set. Now, what is input size in case of graph? What is that we need to give? How many vertices are there in the graph? We need to tell. How many edges are there in the graph? Also, we need to say. Okay, no. So, number of vertices and the number of edges, that becomes input size in case of graph-related problems. Graph-related problems. Now, if it is a searching problem, what is input size? What is input size in case of searching problem? What is input size? What is searching problem? We are given a sequence of elements. Okay, a sequence of elements. And we are also given one more element. We need to determine whether that element is present in given sequence or not. We need to present whether given element is present in that sequence or not. Here, what is input size? What is input size? Please respond. What is input size? Here also number of elements. How many elements are there in the sequence? No, that becomes our input size. In case of searching problem also input size is n. In case of matrix related problem, input size is number of rows as well as number of columns. Number of columns. So all of you should understand what is input size. Input size is the size of the input, size of the input. So what does size of input mean? How many elements are given to us in case of sorting problem? In case of searching problem, that is also number of elements. In case of graph related problem, number of vertices as well as number of edges. In case of matrix related problems, number of rows as well as number of columns. That becomes input size. Input size. Next. So we have understood what is a problem. That means whenever we say problem, we are talking about some computational problem. There is some computation involved in it. And we want some computing device to solve that problem. Okay. But how does a computing device solve the problem? It doesn't solve on its own. No. It doesn't solve on its own. It doesn't solve on its own. So what is that we need to do? We need to tell that computing device what are the sequence of steps it has to perform. To transform input to output. To transform.
Sir, one second.
Okay.
Dear participants, please mute your audio. Suppose sir ask any question, mean at that time only you unmute your audio, then speak to sir. Otherwise, you mute your audio. Okay, sir, you continue, sir.
Okay, thank you, madam. Okay. So input we need to transform to output. For that, we need to write some sequence of steps. That sequence of steps in the language in which that computer understands. Okay, now. So for that sequence of steps, there is some name. All of you must be knowing that we call it as an algorithm. That more formal definition I will explain you in next slide. So where does this word algorithm has come from? Because many of you are from mathematic background, you must be knowing this person, Al-Khwarizmi. Who is also considered as father of some discipline of mathematics. What is the discipline? Al-Khwarizmi is considered as father of some discipline of mathematics. What is that? Please respond, at least one of you. He is considered as father of algebra. Al-Khwarizmi is considered as a Persian scholar, lived in 9th century. He was the person who spread the use of this number system 0, 1, 2, 9. Those were the digits invented in India. Later, he spread the use of this. Next entire world started using. Now, whatever decimal system we are calling it as. Indo-Arabic system. And he was the first person who systematically studied solving linear as well as quadratic equations. And he authored books. That the books were Latinized, translated into Latin language. In that Latin language, Al-Khwarizmi's name also, it was difficult for them somehow. They translated it as Algorithmi. algorithmi, MI. From that, the word algorithm has come from. Algorithm word has come from the name of father of algebra, Al-Khwarizmi. Al-Khwarizmi. It is only Latin translation of his name. It is only Latin translation of his name. Why is it is given that name? He was the first person to systematically study solving step-by-step procedure for solving linear as well as quadratic equations. Okay. Now, what is formal definition of this algorithm? An algorithm is a step-by-step procedure for solving well-posed problems. That means properly defined problems. Or a sequence of computational steps that transform input to output. Because any problem, input is there as well as output is there. That's what I showed, sorting problem. That input should be transformed to output. For that, we need to follow some steps. We need to follow some steps. That steps which transform input to output, we call it as an algorithm. There is no unique definition. Different textbooks, they give different definitions. But idea is that. Or a finite set of instructions that you followed accomplishes a particular task. What is that task? That is nothing but that computational problem. That solves computational problem. Okay, so that is called an algorithm. What is an algorithm? It is a step-by-step procedure for solving well-defined or well-posed problems. Okay. Now, simply if I write some sequence of steps, can we call it as an algorithm? No. That simply if I write some sequence of steps, we cannot call it as an algorithm. The number of steps in that algorithm should be finite. Finite number of steps should be there. And algorithm should be correct. Algorithm should be correct. That means for whatever inputs the algorithm, the procedure is written, that all inputs it should give correct answer. Okay, no. Then only we say that the algorithm is correct. And what is the other important thing? There should not be any ambiguity in the lines that we write inside algorithm. There should not be any ambiguity in the lines which we write inside algorithm. Whoever reads algorithm all should understand in the same way. There should not be any scope for misinterpretation. Misinterpretation. That we call it as an algorithm. That we call it as an algorithm. For example, here this is one sorting problem. This is an algorithm. This is step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4. Like that, we have different steps. This entire thing, we call it as an algorithm, provided it has some properties. Proper input should be there. Output should be there. It should terminate in finite amount of time. Okay, no, there should not be any ambiguity in the lines that we write. If it is like that, then we call it as an algorithm. We call it as an algorithm. Okay, now we call it as an algorithm. Now, what does complexity of an algorithm mean? So we have written correct algorithm. When do you say that an algorithm is correct? When do we say that an algorithm is correct? Please respond. When do we say that an algorithm is correct?
By getting correct answer, sir.
That is, any problem we have input and output. No, any algorithm also input will be there, output. For whatever inputs that algorithm is written, all possible inputs, it should give correct answer. Even for one input, if it gives wrong answer, we say that algorithm is not correct. For all possible input instances, it should give correct answer. Then only we say that algorithm is correct. Next, to solve a problem, we have written correct algorithm. Next, now simply if I write algorithm, that means there are some sequence of steps. If I follow that steps, we get answer. But we don't want to solve that problem. We want some computing device to solve it for us. Then, so if a computing device has to solve it for us, then this algorithm, these steps must be transformed to the language in which that computing device understands, no? Or, see, computing device only should solve it for us. Once we go for translating this algorithm into language in which that computing device understands, that we can do in two ways. One is this algorithm, we can code it in some language which is convenient to us. Then we use some other translator which translate that into the language which your computer understands, that is zeros and ones. We have an algorithm. That algorithm should be written in the language in which that computer understands. For that, what we do is, for example, we have C language, C++ language, Java, Python, like this. So this algorithm, we write in that language so that we get a program. That program we need to store in computer memory. For that, some space is required. Next. That program, it is there in computer memory. If I give some input, it has to process that input. It has to give me output. For that, some CPU time is required. That means this any algorithm, when we go for implementation, that we call it as implementation, we'll get a program. That program requires two resources. What are they? One is CPU time. What is the other one? Memory. One is CPU time, the other one is memory. CPU time and the other one is memory. Now, given an algorithm, how to find out what is the amount of CPU time that algorithm requires? So given algorithm, how to find what is the amount of memory that algorithm requires? That's what we need to find. Those are the two resources an algorithm requires. One is CPU time, the other one is memory. Memory means storage space. Now, what is complexity of this algorithm? Simply, complexity of algorithm is the amount of resources. These two resources this algorithm requires. Next one is, so we have an algorithm, we have a problem, step well-defined problem. To solve that problem, we have algorithm. The algorithm contains a sequence of steps, which is correct algorithm. Input is there, output is there. It terminates in finite amount of time. And there is no ambiguity in the instructions. Everything is clear. Algorithm is correct algorithm. Okay. Now, if I simply have algorithm, I don't get output from input. Okay, now what is that we need to do? That two algorithm we should be explained in the language in which that computing device understands. For that, we code it, we'll get a program. Again, one more translator that's translate into zeros and ones, machine code. Okay. Now that algorithm, I need to find what is the amount of time that algorithm takes. That is called complexity of that algorithm. No, that is called complexity. Now, question is, you have an algorithm. We have a problem. Very good, well-defined problem. To solve that problem, we have an algorithm also. Next, if you have an algorithm, what is the amount of time this algorithm takes to solve that problem? Now question is, to solve a problem, we have an algorithm. So what is the amount of time that algorithm takes to solve that problem? How to answer this question? How do we find that? For that, let me give one simple example. For example, we have a bike or scooty. That scooty, when you buy, you know, they may say that depending on the type of company, it gives 70 kilometers mileage. That means liter petrol, it gives 70 kilometers. You can go 70 kilometers. Now, in highway, if you ride your bike, your scooty, you may get 70 kilometers mileage. Same thing, some normal roads where the road vehicles are coming in both directions and all, you may not get that much mileage. You may get 50 or 40, something like that. Same thing, if you go to a desert, there if you try to ride desert and there if you try to ride, you may not get even 10 kilometers also with 1 liter petrol. You may not get even 10 kilometers mileage also. That means what? If the riding conditions are changing, the mileage is also getting changed. No? Similarly, here, one algorithm I have, and to solve one problem, we have written an algorithm. That what is the amount of time that algorithm takes? This also, similar to this scooter example, this also varies depending on what type of computers or computing devices I am going to run the code for that program, the corresponding program. Depending on the computers or computing devices, this time also changes. Similar to this condition, scooter, that is highway is one, normal roads or desert where full sand is there. So these conditions are changing, then time is also changing. Here also, mileage is changing. Here also same thing, depending on the type of computing device, our time changes. Time changes. Now what is the computing device that we use for our finding the time, finding the amount of time that algorithm takes? The computing device, the computing model that we call it a computational model. The computational model we are using here is one processor machine, only single processor, no multiple processor, random access model of computation, single one, generic one processor random access model of computation. So what does it mean? One processor means here, in any algorithm, what will be there? Some steps with step one, step two, like that, some 30 steps if you write. Step one, either some mathematical operation will be there or some logical operation will be there. No, because CPU has automatic logical unit and control unit, so it performs some automatic or logical operations. So step one, either some addition will be there or multiplication will be there, division or subtraction or some comparison, like that some operations will be there. So what under this model of computation, what is our assumption is each instruction takes constant time, whether it is addition, whether it is multiplication, or whether it is division, or whether it is comparison, all take same amount of time. But it is actually not correct. No, why? Because multiplication is repeated addition. Multiplication should take more time than addition, but for our purpose, we are considering this model, that is RAM model of computation. Okay. Next, instructions are executed one after other. What does it mean? After step one, then only step two is executed. After step two, then only step three. After step three, then only step four. Like that, instructions are executed one after other. There is no parallel execution. Two things happening at the same time. That is not allowed here. And if there are any loops, for example, loops, that means for loop, while loop, like that, if there are any loops, they are not considered as single operations. They are considered as some repeated operations. Okay, no? And most important thing is memory access. So we store data in memory, no? Irrespective of its position, where it is stored in the memory, we should be able to access in same amount of time. That is called random access. That's why our model, the computational model we are using here is RAM model of computation, random access machine model of computation. What are the two main things? All operations take same amount of time. There is no parallel execution. And one more thing is, wherever data is there in memory, same amount of time we can retrieve that. Okay, now under this model of computation, this we have fixed, like a highway or some other normal roads or sand. No, so one condition we have fixed, one model we have taken. Under this model, then what is the running time of an algorithm? What is running time of algorithm? Is number of steps or operations it takes on a given problem instance. How many operations are performed in that algorithm? That we call it as running time of that algorithm. Running time of algorithm means, is it actually time? No. How many operations are performed in that algorithm? That we call it as running time of that algorithm. For example, here, so this is one algorithm. You don't worry about what is that algorithm. So in this algorithm, there are total, say, 8 steps. here, so this is first step. Here some for one loop is there, for loop for j equal to 2 to a length. A is a sequence. That sequence here we call it as array length. Similarly, key equal to a of j. So like that, some instructions are given here. Now here,
excuse me, sir.
In this step one, some operation is performed. In this step two, some operation is performed. Step three, some operation is performed. Step four, some operation is performed. Step five, some operation is performed. Like that, each step some operation is performed. Each step some operation is performed. Now, what we need to do is. For example, we have so is the screen changing now?
No, sir.
Hello?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir, we can see only the screen, that computational model, that PPT. Seventh slide we can see, sir.
Hello?
Hello, yes, sir.
Madam.
Yes, sir.
Whether the screen shared now? Is it changed now? I showed some blank screen. Is it visible now?
No, sir. We can see only the seventh slide.
Yeah. Oh, oh, oh. Now, madam?
No, sir.
Because I am writing something here, I think it is not changing now. Is it changed? No.
No, sir. No, sir. Still, we are in the seventh slide. We can see only the seventh slide.
Okay, madam. Now, madam, same slide?
Yes, sir. We can see the same slide, sir. Seventh, eighth slide.
Oh, okay. At least, okay. Okay, madam. So now, here, for example, we have an algorithm. In algorithm, there are different steps. Different steps, as I showed you in the previous, this one. Madam, is this same,
sir,
screen?
Sir, we can see only slide 8, sir. Slide 8, 8th slide we can see.
Oh, because I opened some other thing, not able to, I think. Is there any way, madam, to share this?
Rani, ma'am?
Yes, one second.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Ma'am, he wants to share some.
Sir? Sir? Now you stop the screen, sir. Then once again, you share it, sir. Stop the screen, sir.
Okay.
Again, you share it, sir. Stop share screen, sir.
Madam, now I think.
Sir,
yes, thank you, madam. Thank you.
Now you started.
Okay. Thank you very much.
Okay, sir.
So, for example, If you take an So in this alg, I think this is not that much clear. No? Step one, step two, step three, and this one step 30. So we have 30 steps in one algorithm, say. So this is step one. This is some step two, this is step three. Like this, we have 30 steps in an algorithm. And this is correct algorithm. Now, what I am saying is, in this step, in step one, either here some arithmetic operation will be there or some logical operation will be there. So here also some arithmetic operation or some logical operation will be there. Here also same thing. Even here also some arithmetic operation or some logical operation will be there. Now what I am saying is, here each step, you calculate what is the operation that is performed. Say here, operation that is performed. Here it may be say addition. Here it may be addition. Here second step, it may be comparison. This may be multiplication. Like that last step also, here it may be some division operation, something like this operation. Now, this how many times this operation is performed also you write. In step one, addition operation is performed, but how many times that operation is performed? That I call it as P1 of N. How many times this operation is performed? That is T2 of N. And this one, how many times this operation is performed? T30 of N. What is N here? N is, whenever I say N means that is input size. N is input size. Now what is that you can do is, this entire algorithm, how many operations are performed? This entire algorithm, how many operations are performed? Number of operations performed here in step one plus number of operations performed in step two plus and so on, number of operations performed in step 30 when N is input size. That entire thing I call it as capital T of N. That, and this algorithm, it is sigma I equal to 1 to N T I of N. That is, in algorithm there are 30 steps. In step one, what is the operation that is performed? Step two, what is the operation you perform? Like that, all steps we write. What is the, and you also write how many times that operation is performed. Step one, T1 of N times. Step two, T2 of N times. Step 30, T30 of N times T is performed. Now, what is the total number of operations performed in this algorithm? What is the total number of operations performed here? It is T1 of N plus T2 of N plus and so on, T30 of N. That we call it as operation count. This operation count only, loosely speaking, we call it as a running time of this algorithm. Running time means it is not actually time. It is operation count only. That is total number of operations performed in our algorithm when N is input size. That we call it as either operation count or running time. So now how to calculate T of N value for each step. How many times each? So for example, here if you see step one, n is input size, length if I consider as n, how many times this operation is performed, you write. Step two, how many times this operation is performed. Step three, how many, here no step, nothing is there, that's why zero. This is n minus one. Okay, step four, how many times it is performed. Step five, like that, all steps you write. Then you take summation of all these things. That we call it as T of n. That we call it as T of n. That we call it as T of n. Here, whatever T of n I said, how we get that? T of n we get by, in algorithm, there are different steps. Each step you calculate what is the operation, that it is the number of times that is performed as a function of input size n, as a function of input size n. Then take summation over all steps. Then take summation over all steps. Okay. Then whatever we get, that we call it as operation count or running time of that algorithm. Loosely speaking, running time of that algorithm. That T of n, for example, to solve a problem, we have an algorithm. Algorithm that T of n is 7n squared plus 8n plus 9. 7n squared plus 8n plus 9. 7n squared plus 8n plus 9. 7n... T of n, that is 7n squared plus 8n plus 9. T of n, that is 7n squared plus 8n plus 9. So in this, as n is very large, For large values of n, T of n, I can say that it is approximately equivalent to 7n squared plus 8n. Do you agree? Provided n is very large. I can even say that if n is in terms of crores, this is approximately equal to 7n squared. If n is very large, I can even say that it is equal to only n squared. It is only n square. This n square we call it as, that is, for large values of n in T of n, we are dropping these lower order terms. We are dropping these lower order terms as well as constant coefficients of highest order term. Constant coefficients of highest order term. This also we are ignoring. Whatever remained is this n square. This n square we call it as. Order of growth or rate of growth. This n square we call it as order of growth or rate of growth of that running time of that algorithm. Order of growth or rate of growth of that algorithm. For T of n, 7n square plus 8n plus 9. for sufficiently large values of n, it is approximately equal to n square. This n square we call it as order of growth or rate of growth of running time of the cell. How did I get that? I dropped lower order terms as well as constant coefficients of highest order term, as well as constant coefficients of highest order term. That we call it as order of growth or rate of growth. Here algorithm B, 4 into 2 power n plus 5 n plus 6. Then what is this value? For large values of n, I can write it as approximate. This smaller terms will go. This term will go. Sorry. This term will go and this term will go. So it will be 4 into 2 power n. Again, 4 is a constant. That also will go. So it is only 2 power n. This we call it as order of growth or rate of growth. So how would you, from T of n, how are you getting order of growth or rate of growth? By dropping lower order terms as well as constant coefficients of highest order term, whatever remains, that we call it as order of growth or rate of growth of that algorithm. Is that clear? Is that clear? Now you tell me, out of these two algorithms, solve the problem correctly. These two are correct algorithms. Which algorithm is better? Algorithm A is better or algorithm B is better? Algorithm A is better or algorithm B is better? Please respond. See, to solve a problem, we have two different algorithms, say algorithm A and algorithm B. Algorithm A has running time like this. Algorithm B has running time like this. Okay. Out of these two, which is better? Please respond.
Algorithm B, sir. Algorithm B.
Algorithm B.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, any other?
Sir, algorithm B, sir.
Algorithm B, madam?
Yes, sir. Algorithm B.
Okay. That I'll check. Now here, if you take n equal to 1, n equal to 1. If you take n equal to 1, 1 is 7n square plus 8n plus 9. The other one is 4 into 2 power n. 4 into 2 power n, this is 4 into 2 power n plus 5n plus 6. 5n plus 6. Oh, sorry. 5n plus 6. Out of these two, which is better? N equal to 1, if I take, what are the values? If I take n equal to 1. N equal to 1, if I take, what are the values? N equal to 1, what is this value? 4 into 2 power 1, 8 plus 5 plus 6, 19. N equal to 1, if I take here, 7 plus 8 plus 9, 24. Okay. N equal to 2, if I take, this is 4 into 4. Plus 10 plus 6. 4 into 4, 16 plus 16, 32.
32.
And this is 28 plus
16
plus 9. This is 25 plus 28, that is 53, na?
Yes.
Okay.
53.
So similarly, on this one, you take n equal to 10, if I take, this will be easy. This will be 789. This will be 789. What about this value? 4 into 2 power 10 plus 5 into 10 plus 6. Plus 6. So this is 2 power 10 means 1024 into 4 plus 56. This is 1024 means this is 4096, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, 56.
Yes.
Okay. So for the, this okay anyhow. This is more than four. This is 4,152. Correct now. So one, it is 4 × 2⁴ + 5n + 6. The other one is 7 × n². 7 × n² 7 × n² + 8n + 9. For this we have got n equal to 1, this is 24. Here it is 19. Here it is 19. Here it is 24. So which algorithm is actually better? Whichever algorithm, number of operations is more is better, or number of operations is less is better?
Less is better, sir.
Less is better. So that means, that's why some people said this is better. Why? Because here it is less. If I take for n equal to 2, here it is 32, here it is 53. Which is better? This one only, 4 × 2⁴ only better. But if I take n equal to 10, if I take n equal to 10, n equal to 10, this value is 4152. This is 789. Which is better? Which is lower? Which is
53.
This is 789 is smaller. No, 789 is smaller than 4152.
Yes, sir.
That means which algorithm should be better? This algorithm is better, or A. This algorithm is better? This
algorithm
A. This is A. This is our algorithm B.
A is better, sir.
For some values, A is better. Some values, B is better. Correct? No. For some values, A is better. Some values, B is better. But we are interested in only for large value. For example, if I say you are a principal madam or HOD madam is sitting in her car, and one student is standing. One MSc student is standing. Okay, no, they just, and the distance is only 50 meters or 35 meters. Now, HOD madam is there in her car and the student is standing. There is a race, okay, to reach that 35 meters. Who reaches fast? HOD madam can reach in car faster, or the student can reach faster?
HOD ma'am, sir.
But the distance is only 35. By the time madam starts and changes the gear, no, that because 35 meters, immediately student can go there, no?
Yes, sir.
Yes. Does it mean that student can run faster than HOD madam's car?
No.
No.
It depends on the distance.
Because if I simply ask a question, whether HOD madam's car goes faster or student can go faster, your answer is obvious answer, that HOD madam's car only goes faster. Why? You internally assume that if distance is more, then HOD madam will be reaching very much faster than that student. Because a smaller distance, automatically you are eliminating, no? If it is 10 meters, student only will go faster. Why? Because before they change gear and all, no, madam, the student can reach. Is it clear? Similar to that, here also, whichever algorithm is better means, input sizes, we should take very large values. For large values, whichever algorithm number of operations is performed is less. Whichever algorithm number of operations is performed is less, we say that algorithm is better. Now you tell me which algorithm is better. Algorithm A is better or algorithm B is better?
A is better.
Algorithm A is very much faster when compared, because 10 itself it is like this. If I take 100, no, this value will be very large value. This is smaller value. Okay. That's why algorithm A is very much better than algorithm B. Algorithm A is very much better, faster than algorithm B. Algorithm B. Here is order of growth. Now what is that? How to say that? That we are telling only based on order of growth. For large values of n, it is n squared. This is polynomial function. This is exponential function. Polynomial function value is very much small for large values of n when compared with exponential function. That's why we say that algorithm A is very much better than algorithm B. Now, final question is, to solve a problem, if you have two different algorithms, which algorithm is better? Which algorithm is better? Which algorithm is better? Please respond. Which algorithm is better?
Which contains a less number of repetitions, sir.
But that too we are not able to say no. Why? Because for some values one is containing less, for some values the other one is containing less. No. To rectify that, I explained whichever has lower order of growth, less order of growth. So this is finally everything will come in terms of n. Here it is n square, it is 2 power n. If n square and 2 power n is given, immediately you say that 2 power n is large when compared with n square. No.
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So now what is the final conclusion? To solve a problem, if we have two different algorithms, which algorithm is better? Whichever algorithms order of growth growth is less, that algorithm is better. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Now what is order of growth? 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 What is order of growth?
Number of times the thing will be repeated like that, sir.
No. Order of growth is in the running time. I have already told you what is running time. No, T of n, we call it as running time. T of n is running time. What is this T of n? Actually, this is also not time. It is only total number of operations performed. When input size is n. That's what I mentioned. No, input size is n. T of n is total number of operations performed when input size is n. If, for example, T of n is, if T of n equals to 4 into n cube plus 8 into n square plus 9 into n minus 15. Now, what is its order of growth? What is its order of growth? It is n cube. How did you get, madam? How did we get that n cube?
Sir, by eliminating the constants and
n square.
Because in this expression, these are all smaller terms, no?
Yeah, it's the major
one. So you simply discard this. Now, as well as, because there is some constant in the highest term, no? This also ignore. Whatever remains, that is n cube. This n cube. This we call it as order of growth or rate of growth. Is it okay? But in n cube, that is order of growth. Whichever has lower order of growth, that we say that algorithm is better. And this kind of what does analysis of algorithm mean? Analysis of algorithm means, I have mentioned, no, any algorithm requires two resources, CPU time and memory. Predicting the resources this algorithm requires, that is known as analysis of algorithms. Okay. What is the amount of CPU time my algorithm takes? Directly by seeing that algorithm, we cannot say no. We should go for actually a program. We should write for that. We should give input. That input, so we get output from that. For that, what is the time it has taken? We need to calculate. But we are not doing all those things. By seeing algorithm itself, we are saying what is the amount of time this algorithm takes if I go for RAM model of computation. Is that okay? What does analysis of algorithm mean? Please respond. What does analysis of algorithm mean?
CPU time and memory, sir.
That is, given algorithm, we need to calculate what is the amount of CPU time my algorithm takes, what is the amount of memory our algorithm takes. That is called analysis of algorithm. Okay, now that we are predicting the resources that algorithm requires. That is known as analysis of algorithm. But we are doing analysis only for large values of n, no. And this type of analysis, we call it as asymptotic analysis of algorithms. Okay. Now, what is order of growth of example one?
N cube, sir.
N cube. What is order of growth of example 2?
N square.
N square. Why? Because after removing all those things, we get. What is order of growth of example 3?
Yes, sir.
Order of growth of example 3?
Highest means 3 power n, sir.
Example 3 is?
3 power n, sir.
What is order of growth of example 3? What is order of growth of example 3?
Sir, 3 power n.
3 power n, thank you. Okay, now that's what I said. An algorithm is more efficient than another if its running time has a lower order of growth. Lower order of growth. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, for example, T of n equal to 30. What is its order of growth? T of n equal to 30. What is its order of growth?
1, sir.
Always order of growth is function of n, no?
Yes, because n is not there in the function.
So n is not there. So what is that we are doing is, this can be written as 30 into 1. Is it okay? 30 can be written as 30 into 1, no?
Yes, sir. That is what n, one time, sir.
This I can write as 1, I can write it as n power 0, no? Okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, this is our T of n. In this, only one term is there. Only one term is there. So what is that we need to do? We need lower order terms are not there. Only one term is there. Then what is that I need to do? Drop only constant coefficients of this highest order term. What are the constant coefficients? Only this is constant coefficients. Then what is that I have got? N power 0. This n power 0 is order of growth of T of n. N power 0 means 1. That means order of growth of T of n is, what is order of growth of T of n? Hereafter I use OOG. OOG. Order of growth of T of n is 1. How did I get? This is n power 0. Is that okay? T of n is equal to 40,
Same.
If T of n equal to 2?
1, sir.
That is also 1. Same, we should not write 2 here, 40 here. Here also order of growth is n power 0. OOG is n power 0. Here also order of growth is n power 0. Even here also order of growth is n power 0. 30 also order of growth is n power 0. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
What does n power 0 mean? F of n equal to n power 0. If I say something like that, what does it mean? Value is independent of n. No? N is equal to 1 also, it is 1 power 0. 2 also, 1 power 0. 3 also, 3 power 0. 4 also, 4 power 0. It is not depending on n itself. No, if I change n also, no change in my answer, final value.
Yes,
that
sir.
That order of growth is called constant order of growth. That is called constant order of growth. Constant order of growth means what? Constant order of growth means?
Even if you change the value of n, the value won't change.
The value, that means it is n power 0 actually. It is n power 0. Is that clear?
Yes, sir.
N power 0. Okay, n power 0. Now these are basic orders of growth. Yeah, n power 0 means 1. 1 means here n power 0. 1 means it is not only 1. 2 is also 1. 3 is also 1. 40 is also 1. Any constant is 1. Actually, order of growth is in terms of input size. So that's why it is 1. Log n. If I start a term is log n, that is called logarithmic algorithm. If it is n, that is called linear algorithm. N log n, linear arithmetical, linear logarithmic. I think this is logarithmic. N square, quadratic. N cube, cubic. Like this, these are algorithms. Now, one algorithm has one order of growth. Another algorithm has log n. Which algorithm is better out of these two? One algorithm has order of growth 1. One algorithm has order of growth log n. Which algorithm is better?
One is better, sir.
One is better. One algorithm has log n, other one has n. Which is better? Better means faster. Which is better? One has log n, other one has n. For large values of n, log n value is more or n value is more?
N value is more.
That means log n time algorithm is better or n time algorithm is better?
Log n.
One is n, the other one is n log n. Which is better?
N log n.
No, n log n value is more than n, no?
N is better, sir.
One is n log n, other one is n square. Which is better? N log n is better. Like that, this is increasing order, no? It is in increasing order. One is 2 power n, another one is n cubed. Which is better?
N cube.
One is n power 1 crore, other one is 2 power n. Which is better? N power 1 crore, other one is 2 power n. Which is better?
N power 1 crore.
N power 1 crore is very much less value. Why? Because if you take n very large, you know, n power 1 crore is very much smaller than 2 power 1 crore. Are you getting? Okay.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So these are the order of growth in increasing order. And this way of analyzing algorithm is called asymptotic analysis of algorithms. Okay, no, that is called asymptotic analysis of algorithm. What does it mean? So you can be analyzing the running time of algorithm for large input sizes so that only order of growth matters. That is called asymptotic running time of algorithm. Okay. And for this, we use different asymptotic notations. Okay, no, that I will like explain next. Okay. This asymptotic notation, always, whenever we say n here, f of n, t of n, all these things, n, here n denotes input size. N, what are the values input size can take? Either no input, that means 0, or input size is 1, or input size is 2, or 3, like that. It is non-negative integers. N takes non-negative integers. Okay. Non-negative integers. Now, for example, f of n and g of n, we have two functions. And g of n two functions where n takes value in the set 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on. Non-negative set of non-negative integers. N belongs to this. If n1 is less than or equal to n2, then f of n1 is less than or equal to f of n2. If this condition is guaranteed, if n1 is less than or equal to n2, then f of n1 is less than or equal to f of n2. Then this function is called what? This function is called, what type of function is this?
Non-decreasing function.
Monotonically increasing function. Monotonically
increasing
function. Monotonically increasing function. Say f of n and g of n both are monotonically increasing functions. F of n is also monotonically increasing, and g of n is also monotonically increasing. F of n, g of n are both are monotonically increasing, where n takes value in the set 0, 1, 2, 3. Okay? Why should I take this condition? In algorithm, for example, distance you take from Chennai to Hyderabad, Chennai to Singapore. Chennai to Hyderabad, Chennai to Singapore. Which has lower distance, less distance?
Chennai to Hyderabad.
But Chennai to Hyderabad, minimum it may take 8 hours, 9 hours. If you, okay, no. If you are coming by train or something like that, okay? Chennai to Dubai, it should take, Singapore, it should take more time or less time?
More time or less time?
More time.
If distance is more, the amount of time it takes also should be more, no? If distance is less, the amount of time it takes also should be less, no? Because usually that is considered. No, sir, if distance is more, okay, but still there are very good flights, they reach faster. But Chennai to Hyderabad, there are no normal flights only, they take more time. That is not correct. Okay, no, here our assumption is, if distance is more, time should be more. Distance is less, time should be less. Similarly, in algorithm point of view also, input size is more, number of steps should be more, or at least the same as previous one. At least the same as previous one. If number of input size is more, number of steps should be more or at least same as previous one. That's why this condition, monotonically increasing condition. Monotonically increasing condition. So f of n and g of n are monotonically increasing functions. F of n and g of n are monotonically increasing functions. Then what is, we have this five asymptotic notations. Okay, no, very easy. You can easily understand. F of n and g of n are monotonically increasing. Now what is big O? This we read it as big O. What does big O of g of n mean? What does big O of g of n mean? What does it mean? What does big O of g of n mean? What does big O of g of n mean? Big O of g of n mean?
Ne nidra bola. Kalu muska vintana.
Means? It is a set. It is a set which contains all functions in n, say f of n, such that order of growth of f of n is less than or equal to order of growth of g of n. So big O of g of n is a set which contains all functions in n. But what is the guarantee you need to give? Order of growth of this is less than or equal to order of growth of g of n. Now, for example, if g of n is n squared, then what is this big O of n squared? What is big O of n squared? It is a set. Now, what are the elements in this set? It contains all functions. It contains all functions in n such that what is the guarantee? Such that what is the guarantee? Order of growth of that function should be less than or equal to order of growth of n squared. Order of growth of that function should be less than or equal to order of growth of n squared. Can you give me a function whose order of growth is lower than n squared?
N.
Less than, n. Thank you, madam. N. Next. N. Next.
One also we can tell, sir. One.
One also. Thank you, madam. One is also n power 0 only, no? Next. Next.
Log n.
Log n, thank you. Log n. Next.
A constant function.
Constant we have already written, no, madam. One means log n power 0 only, no? Log n. Next. N log n, is it small? 2n plus 3, is it small or not? 4n squared plus 5n plus 6. What is the order of growth of this?
N square, sir.
N square. Order of growth of this is n square. Okay? It is less than or equal to n square or not? Yes. What is the order of growth here? What is the order of growth here?
N.
It is less than or equal to n square or not? Yes. What is the order of growth here? N log n. Is it less than or equal to n square or not? Yes. We take n into n plus 1 by 2. Is it less than or equal to n square or not?
Less than, sir.
Ah, correct. Ah, it's same. N, this is also n square only. No, 1 by 2 into n square plus 1 by 2 into n, no? So this will go, finally it is n square only, no? 3n, 4n, all are less than or equal like this. Now you tell me, is this finite set or infinite set?
Infinite, sir.
Infinite set. Okay, no. Now, big O of n square is a set. Big O of n square is a set. What are the elements in that set? It contains all elements, all functions in n, whose order of growth is either equal to n square or lower than n square. Now, you tell me, n square plus 4, 3n square plus 4, belongs to big O of n square. Is this a true or false?
True, sir.
This is true. Why? Because this order of growth is n square. Whether I have written here or not, that is different. But if this order of growth is n square, this is n square. Less than or equal to n square. Condition is true. 5n power 4 plus 6 belongs to big O of n square. What about this?
False.
No, it is
false,
not, sir.
This is false. Now, is that a clear definition of big O?
Order of growth of f of n supposed to be less than or equal to order of growth of g of n.
Gfn. That's all. Now, we see big O of n squared here. N squared is okay. N power 1.5, okay. 5, 200, 1, 3, like this, so many functions. Is it finite set or infinite set? Infinite. Infinite set. Is that okay?
Excuse me, sir. Sorry, madam. Why don't we take n plus 2 and also n plus 2 like n plus 4?
That is also correct, madam. That is also correct. N plus 2 is also order of growth is n, no? That is also correct. N plus 3 also correct. N minus 2 also correct. Whatever you want, you can write in terms of n, madam. Guarantee is order of growth is less than or equal to n square. That's all.
Okay. Thank you.
Okay. Now, what is big omega of g of n? Similarly, what is big omega of g of n? This is second notation. What is big omega of g of n? What is the change here? Here change is, instead of this less than or equal to, we'll have greater than or equal to. This is big omega. Big omega of g of n is f of n such that order of growth of f of n is greater than or equal to order of growth of g of n. Order of growth of g of n. Is that clear? Whatever you write here, this order of growth must be same as this or even more than that. More than this. Okay, now we'll see example here. See, what is big omega of g of n? Big omega of n square is n square. Is it correct or not? Is it member
yes,
in
sir.
The set or
yes,
not?
Sir.
N power 2.5. Is it member or not?
Yes, sir.
2 power n, 3 power n, all are more. So these are members in this set. That is big omega of g of n. Now similarly, what is theta of n? It is exactly equal, order of growth point of view. Theta of n square. N square is there or not?
Yes, sir.
Both have same order of growth, f of n and g of n. Is it correct or not? Yes. N into n plus 1 by 2?
Yes, sir.
This is also n square only, no? 8n square plus 9n plus 20
is also
n square. this is also only writing different style, but this is also n squared. No, n and 4 will come this side. It is also n squared. So first one is like here, this is simple terms we can say analogous to our actual so we if we have two real numbers a and b to compare this we have less than or equal to greater than or equal to equals to strictly less than strictly greater than no here similarly if f of n and g of n are two functions in order of growth point of view we have this analogous to this we have big O analogous to this we have big omega analogous to this we have theta this little o this is small little omega or small omega that means what here f of n is less than or equal to g of n but order of growth point of view only not exact value this is order of growth point of view similar to this we have big o similar to this we have big omega now can we say that 7n square plus 8n plus 9 is n square. Can you write like this? Is it correct?
Yes, sir.
No, no, correct. This is wrong. This is wrong. How 7n square plus 8n plus 9 is equal to n square? It is only we can
order.
Say, but we
order.
Can. Ah, that is odd.
Order.
After dropping lower order terms as well as constant coefficients, then I can say that it is n square. For that we have this. Is belongs to big O of n square. This is correct, but this is wrong. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Now, for example, 7n square plus 8n plus 9 is 3n square plus 4. Is this correct?
No, sir.
No, this is wrong. But this I can say that 7n square plus 8n plus 9, if you want. We can say that it is theta of n squared. This is correct. Even this also I can write the theta of n squared. Okay, that is the difference. Okay, so theta of n squared means this. Little o means strictly high, lower. Little o of n squared is n power 1.5. These are strictly lower than n squared. Little omega means strictly higher, n square, n power 2.5, 2 power n. These are all larger values than this. Okay. Now small digit type. You tell me. You should answer. Order of growth of this is n cube. We know that. Hence, 8n cube plus this is big O of n cube. Is it true or false? Is that true
sir.
Or false? True.
True,
yes,
sir.
Thank
true,
you,
true, sir.
Thank you. What about this? Equals to or belongs to? I use interchangeably. Both are same. Intention is this is an element in this set. Is it true or false?
Yes, sir. True, sir.
True.
It's,
correct.
It's true,
because
sir.
This is less than or equal to n power 4.
Yes.
True. What about third one?
It's a false, sir.
This is false. What about fourth one?
It's
also false. It's false, sir.
But this is true, no, madam. Why? Because big omega, this side
greater
is
greater than or
greater
equal
than
to. Equal to. Right, right, right.
So
equal
that's
to.
Why it is true.
Yes, sir.
Okay. What about fifth one?
It's also true, sir.
That is true. Why? Because it is more. Still okay.
Yes, sir.
No problem.
Yes.
What about sixth one?
False, sir.
True, sir.
This is true. Why? Because big omega, this side it can be equal or more. It is the n cube, this is n square. N cube is more than n square, no?
Yes, sir.
So that's why it is true or false finally?
True, sir.
True,
sir.
Okay. Yeah, seventh one?
False.
False. Why? Because it should be only n cube. This is both are equal, no? False. Eighth one?
True, sir.
True. Ninth one?
No, false, sir.
False.
False.
Ninth one is false. Why? Because it should be strictly lower. N cubed is not allowed. N power 2.99, that is allowed. Okay? This is false. Tenth one?
False, sir.
Tenth one. Yep.
True, sir.
It is true. Why? Because it is strictly lower. No. It is N cubed, this is N power 4. True. 11th one?
False, sir.
False. Why? Because it should be strictly higher. Equal is not allowed. That's why false. 12th one?
True, sir.
True. Okay, now these are these notations. Okay? These five notations, whatever I explained, no? These are called asymptotic notation. This is asymptotic analysis of algorithm. And these are formal definitions. If you want to show that f of n is big O of g of n, this is the definition, this inequality. So this inequality, satisfying this inequality, we need to find c and n naught. Okay, no. Like this inequality, we need to find c and n naught. For example, if you are asked to show that 7n plus 1 is big O of n, we know that is true. But how to prove that? How to prove this, show this? For that, we have this formal definitions. Using formal definitions, we can show that.
Excuse me, sir.
Madam.
Sir, one of the participants raised a doubt.
Tell me, madam.
What will happen if we give negative powers to n?
Negative powers to n, that will be smaller than, that is even smaller than constant. It is like 1 by n.
Yes.
N like power minus 1 by n,
1 by n square.
Constant time algorithm is better than 1 by n, but practically, as input size increases, we will not have any algorithm where time reduces. That type of algorithms will not be there, no, madam.
Okay, sir. Thank you so much.
Okay. So, to show that these are the formal definitions, this I am not doing. I just wanted to show you. Satisfying this inequality, we need to find these two constants. Once you find these two constants, that is over. We can show that by the actual definition, that is true. Here our constant is, one is 8, other one is 1. Hence, we say that by the formal definition, these are true. Similarly, for big omega also, we have formal definition. Here also, two constants we need to find. For theta also, we have formal definition. We need to find three constants like this. For little o also, we have formal definition. F of n by g of n equal to 0. Then this, using limits, we need to do it. For little omega also, we have like this. Now, what does this theorem say? If you are given a polynomial whose degree is m, polynomial in n whose degree is m, then we can say that this is big O of n power m. For example, if I say that f of n equals to 20 into n power 5 plus 21 into n power 4 plus 22 into n cube plus 23 into n plus 5, then what is its order of growth? N power 5. Why? Because degree is n power 5. Degree is 5, that's why it is n power 5. We can say that is big O of n power m. Is that okay? Now what I am saying is, if f of n is t of n equal to 4 into n power 200 plus 5 into n power 50 plus 6 into n square minus 7 into n plus 30, then what is its order of growth?
N power 200, sir.
N power 200. Because its order of growth is n power 200, I can easily say that it is big O of n power 200. No. Provided this constant is not equal to 0. If it is 0, then that is it. Okay? T of n is big O of n power 200. Is that okay? Now the same T of n, I can also write it as big O of n power 2000. Is this correct? T of n is big O of n power 2000. Is this correct? Is this true or false?
Not true, sir.
True only. Why? Because this order of growth is 200. This is less than or equal to 2000. No. I can even write it as 2000 n power 20,000. Is this correct?
True, sir.
N power 2 lakhs. Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
N power 2 crores, I think it is. N power 2 crores, is it 2 crores or 20 crores? Okay, now, is this true?
Yes, sir.
This is also true. If all are true, among this, which is our favorite answer? This is also true. This is also true. This is also true. This is also true. Even this is also true. Which is our favorite answer? All five are true here. But which is our favorite? This first one is our favorite. Why? Because it is close to actual order of growth, no? It is close to actual order of growth. It is close to actual order of growth. Are you getting?
Yes, sir.
See, for example, you want to buy one book. Okay, now Introduction to Algorithms by Thomas H. Korman. The actual cost is 800. One student said it is not. One student said it is not more than 20 crores. One student said it is not more than 2 lakhs. One student said it is not more than 1 lakh. One student said it is not more than 1,000. One student said it is not more than 800. Among all this, if no student is lying, then which answer is correct? Which answer gives more information? One is 2 crores, less than or equal to 2 crores, less than or equal to 2 lakhs, less than or equal to 1 lakh, less than or equal to 1,000, less than or equal to 800. Then which gives more information about actual cost of the book?
800, sir.
800 is not there. Less than or equal to 1,000, less 200. Than or equal to 850 is there. Less than or equal
to 1,000, less than or equal to 850, sir.
850. So now you tell me what type of bound this big O notation gives? Upper bound it gives. What type of bound this big O notation gives? Upper bound. But this upper bound should be as small as possible. This upper bound should be as small as possible. If it's small, upper bound is smaller, then it is better for us. It is very much close to our actual running time, that order of growth of running time of that algorithm. Is that okay? Similarly, in terms of big omega, for example, T of n here, I can write T of n equal to big omega of 1. Is this correct? T of n is big omega of 1. Is this correct or not? Is that correct or not? T of n is big omega
yes,
of
sir.
1.
Yes,
why?
Sir.
Because
yes.
This is n power 200, this is n power 0 only, no? More.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Big omega of n power 10, is this correct or not? N power 10, is this correct or not?
Correct, sir.
Like this, if I have represented N power 180, all is there anything wrong among these five?
No, sir.
All are correct. Among this, which is your favorite answer?
N power 180.
This is your favorite answer. So big omega notation gives what type of bound?
Lower bound.
Lower bound must be as high as possible. Then it gives more information about actual value of T of n. Is that okay?
Yes, sir.
Big O notation gives upper bound. Big omega gives lower bound. Okay, now this should be small. This should be large. Okay, now. Okay, so that is about this. Next one is, madam. That HOD madam and
yes sir.
I need some time. If you don't have any problem, then I'll continue for some time because that the title. No,
okay sir. Okay sir. No issues sir.
Okay. Whenever you want me to stop, you tell me 2 minutes before that time I stop. Okay na?
Okay sir.
Okay. So next one is you are given an algorithm. How to analyze that algorithm? You are given an algorithm. How to analyze that? What does analysis of algorithm mean? predicting the resources that the algorithm requires. That is known as analysis of algorithm. What is the amount of time it takes? What is the amount of space it takes? Now we are going to calculate only time. What is the amount of time that algorithm takes? Now, time complexity of non-recursive algorithm, that is iterative algorithms. Now decide on parameter indicating input size. Anyhow, once sorting problem, what is the input size parameter? Number of elements given to us, that is n. Identify the algorithm's most important operation. Why we are concentrating on this most important operation? Why? Because in T of n, we are dropping lower order terms as well as constant coefficients, no? And we are term. If that is the case, we need not calculate for all steps. We need not calculate for all steps. You calculate for only those steps where most of the work is done. That we call it as most important operation, that is basic operation. Next, check whether the number of times the basic operation is executed depends only on the input size. This I'll explain in the next slide. Next, set up the expression some number of times algorithm basic operation is executed, determine order of growth. Okay. Now this is simple algorithm. It finds sum of all elements in given sequence, or here we call it as an array. In array, there are n elements. How to find sum of all elements in that array? How to find sum of all elements in that array? How to find sum of all elements in the array? How to find sum of all elements in that array? So we have an array. This is A of one. It is like sequence A1, A2, A3, A4. Now like that, here we have array 4. This is say 20, this is 45, this is 30, this is 34. How to find sum of this array name is A. How to find sum? Initially sum you consider it as 0. Then this you add sum equal to previous sum plus A of one. First one. Next again sum equal to like this four times if I do I will get sum of all elements in this array. No, is that okay? I equal to 1 you do, I equal to 2 also you do, I equal to 3 also you do, I equal to 4 also you do. But what is the step I am performing for each I? Sum equal sum plus A of 1 I have written for 1. In general sum plus I varies from, I takes value from 1 to 4. Is that okay? Next it will be 20 plus 45. Next it will be 20 plus 45 plus 30. Next 20 plus 45 plus 30 plus 34. That's what we have written here. For that we have written one for loop, sum equals sum plus A of I. This is the thing. What is the first thing that we need to do here? What is input size? What is input size? How many elements are given to us? That is our input size. How many elements are given to us? How many elements are given to us? 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 elements are given to us. That's why n equal to 4. That n, it becomes our input size. N equal to 4. That is our input size. What next? What is the next one? What is most important operation among all these? This is assignment operation. This is addition and increment, comparison and incrementation. This is actual addition, actual work we are doing here. This addition operation, I call it as most important operation. I am not worried about what is happening here, what is happening here, what is happening here. I am only interested in this. Why? Because for large values of n, this operation only is performed maximum number of times. Highest order term, this operation only, this step only gives me highest order term, so that I will get order of growth by simply calculating for this. I need not do this anything for this. I need not do anything for this. That we call it as addition operation. Next, third step, as I showed you, you check whether the number of times basic operation is executed depends only on the input size or not. What that means? What does it mean? Number of additions performed here. How many additions are performed when n equal to 4? how many additions are performed when n equals 4? How many additions are performed when n equals 4? Please respond. How many additions are performed when n equals 4?
4,
how
sir?
Many? 4. If there are only 3 elements, how many additions are performed?
3, sir.
5 elements? 5.
5, sir.
20 elements? 20. So that's what is written here. See. How many operations are performed here? Here, whatever be the n value, that many operations are performed. That's what here it is written now. Check whether the number of times that a basic operation is performed, executed, depends only on the input size. Is it depending only on input size or some other things? It depends only on input size, no? Why? Because n equal 4, 4 times, n equal 5, 5 times, n equal to 20, 20 times, n equal to 100, 100 times. Like that, it is depending on only input size. Only input size. Depends on only input size. So, now how many, next one is, fourth step is, set up a sum expressing the number of times algorithm's basic operation is performed. Basic operation is performed. Now T of n is the number of times this operation is performed. T of n is, this operation is performed when I equal to 1, I equal to 2, I equal to n also this is performed. That's why sigma I equal to 1 to n, I equal to 1 one time, 2 one time, n also one time. Overall it is n minus 1 plus 1 it equal to n. Now what is its order of growth? What is its order of growth? What is its order of growth?
N, sir.
N, sir.
N, n. So now you tell me what is the running time of this algorithm? What is the running time of this algorithm?
N, sir.
N, sir.
Now we can say that running time T of n equals to what is T of n equals to big O of n, is this correct? T of n equal to big O of n, is this correct? T of n is big O of n, is this correct or not? Because order of growth is n, no. Once order of growth is n, can you say something like this, T of n is big O of n?
Yes, sir.
Correct only, no? That is definition. If it is like this, can we say that it is big O of n square? Is this correct?
No, sir.
It is correct only. Why? Because
less than or equal to. Less than or equal to.
Less than or equal to. Can we say that T of n is big O of n power 3?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. Is it correct? But nobody writes all these things. Why? Because big O, small only we write, no. Whichever is smaller. So that's why this is our favorite answer. These two answers are not our favorite. Okay? This is only our favorite. Now, can you say that T of n is... Okay, that is symbol directly I'll write. Big omega of n, is this correct? T of n is big omega of n, is this correct?
Yes, sir, correct.
Correct. T of n is theta of n, is this correct?
Big omega of what, sir? I didn't see, sir. Big omega of?
N, madam. Second one is big omega of n. Third one is theta of n. Third one is theta of n. Is this correct?
Equal to means theta, sir.
Now T of n I have written as theta of n. Is this correct or not?
Yes, sir. Correct, sir.
Correct. So algorithm running time we can represent using any asymptotic notation. No. Whichever like not on T of n is little o of n. Is this correct? This is little o of n. Is this correct?
No. No, sir.
No, that is wrong. That is, why? Because both are equal. No, you cannot write like this. If you want, we can write n power 1.1. This is correct. N power 1.1. This is correct. Is that okay? Is Is this okay?
Yes,
sir. This is the procedure. This is the procedure. Now, for example, this is simple matrix addition algorithm. Matrix addition algorithm. How to do it? Again, what is the first step? What is the input size parameter? Because this is square matrix addition, number of rows and number of columns both are same. So input size parameter, I can say it as n. Now, what is most important operation here? This orange, this color, orange color. This is addition operation, no? That is addition operation. Next one is, in matrix addition, how does it, in matrix, we have 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, this matrix plus 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. We have this matrix. Now, what is that we do? This corresponding entries we add now 2 plus 7 plus 3 plus 8. Plus 4 plus 9 plus 5 plus 10 plus 6 plus 11 7 plus 12. How many additions we perform total in this matrix addition? How many additions we perform?
Six.
What is that 6 here? What is that 6?
Number order of addition performed.
Times not number order. Of columns. Because 2 by product 3 is the matrix. Seven. Number of product of rows and columns. Thank you. Product of rows. Now you tell me. Number of times this addition is performed, it depends only on this. Value or any other things. If I tell you n equal to 5, can you tell me directly what, how many times addition is performed? N equal to 5 means 5 rows and 5 columns. If I tell you input size, I'm able to say how many times that operation is performed, no?
Yes.
It depends only on input size. That's why we can go to expression. How many times this operation is performed? For each value of j, 1 to n, this is performed. That's why sigma j equal to 1 to n one time. But this entire step is performed for each value of I, 1 to n. That's why sigma I equal to 1 to n. If you simplify, you will get n squared. Now, what is order of growth of t of n? N square. Once you know order of growth, now what is running time of this algorithm? T of n equal to big O of n square. Is this correct? T of n is big O of n square. Is this correct? T of n is running time of this matrix addition algorithm.
Yes.
Is this correct?
Yes, sir.
Same thing. T of n is equals to big O of n power 3. Is this correct?
True, yes, sir.
It is correct, but nobody writes this way. It is only for our understanding. Initially, we are discussing like this. But nobody writes this way. Now, if I know that it is n square, what is the use in writing it as n cube? No use. T of n is theta of n square. Is this correct?
Correct, sir.
T of n is big omega of n square. Is that correct? Now, T of n is big omega of n square. Is this correct?
Correct, sir.
Now, among these three are correct. Among these, which is your favorite answer?
Theta of n square, sir.
Thank you very much, madam. Why? It is like big O notation means if I ask what is the cost of the book, you are saying less than or equal to 800. That means it may be 800 or 799 or it can be 600 also, it can be 1 rupee also. Okay. In this case, what does it mean? It is greater than or equal to 800. That means it can be 800 or 801 or 2000 also, 20,000 also. But here you are saying cost of the book is exactly 800 rupees. This is also correct. Then what is our cover rate? It is better to say exactly 800, no? So that's why, which is your cover rate? This theta is our cover rate, no? Okay. So similarly, this simply only just. See, for example, this line. So we are given an array which contains say four elements like this. This is 10. This is 10. This is 20. This is 15. This is 34. It has four elements. This is third person, fourth person. I need to search for an element that I call it as key. Key equal to 30. Now, what is a simple method? First thing is this. If array name is A, compare with. If both are equal, over. If not equal, then. Compare with A of 2, not equal with A of 3. This is a compare with A of 4. Not equal, you say that key is not present. Is this okay? First, we compare with the 10. If not equal, compare with the 20. If not equal, compare with 15. Compare with 10, 20, 34. If it matches, you say that yes, present. Otherwise, compare with all elements and say that it is not present. Is that okay? If you are searching for key 15, then how many times I need to compare? How many times I need to compare? How many times I need to compare? How many times I need to? 3 times only, no, madam.
Okay. Yes.
After
sir,
15, sir. We'll stop now.
Okay.
Key is 15, but our array contains elements like this. This is 15. This is 30, this is 40. How many times I need to compare here?
One time.
This is n value, number of elements is 4. Here also number. Okay. So now this algorithm is called, linear. First compare with first element doing like this. That is shown here. Okay. So here they are comparing with 1. If not equal, they are incrementing it. Then comparing with the 2. Their algorithm, what is most important operation? Element is most important operation, no? Okay. So input size is therefore, I said, no. What is the most important operation? this is comparison. This comparison operation is most important operation. Now, that's here, even if I tell 4, you are not able to say exactly how many times operation is performed. No, here it is. Here it is. In this case, it is 4 times. Here it is only 1 time. Here also n equal 4. Even if I tell you that n equal 4, you are not able to say exactly how many times this operation is performed. No, is that okay? It not only depends on n, it also depends on what are the actual values here. What are the actual values here? It not only depends on but also actual values in the input. Okay, in that case, what we do is here, if you see, let T of n be the number of times basic operation is performed when input size is n. Clearly, the basic operation count T of n not only depends on n, but also in the actual input instance. In this case, key T of n equal to 1. In this case, T of n equal to 4. Correct? No, 20 is here only. 25 is here. 4. 86, it is not at all there. Still, it is 4 times only. Here, 80, it is in second position. So, 22 times. Okay? In this case, not only depends on n, but also actual values in the input. Then what is that I need to do? At least you calculate what is the minimum number of times this operation is performed for any value of n. What is the maximum number of times this operation is performed for any value of n? On average, what is the number of times this operation is performed? On average, what is the number of times this operation is performed? That's what you calculate. That's what you calculate. That we call it. What is the minimum number of times this operation is performed? Whatever be the value of n, what is the minimum number of times that operation is performed?
One time, sir.
At least one time we need to compare. No, at least one time. What is the maximum number of times that operation is performed?
N times.
N times. Okay, no? On average, it will be between 1 and n, no?
Yes,
not,
sir.
Not less than 1, not more than n. Not more than n. So in that case, what we have is, we have three different running times. One is called best case running time. What is the minimum number of times that operation is performed? The other one is, what is the maximum number of times that is performed? That is called worst case running time. On average, what is the number of times that operation is performed? That we call it as average case running time of that algorithm. When do we get the three cases? As I mentioned here, check whether the number of times basic operation is executed depends only on the input size. If it depends only on the input size, we will not have any cases. If not only depends on input size, but also actual instance, then we will have different cases. So those we call it as best case running time, worst case running time, average case running time. For given input, what is the minimum number of times that operation is performed? What is the maximum number of for any input of size n, what is the maximum number of times that operation is performed? On average, what is the number of times? Now, in this case, in the best, in the worst case, what is the number of times this operation is performed? For each value of I from 1 to n, it is performed. No, so that's why it is n. On the best case, what is the number of times this is performed? Only one time. That's why it is 1. Order of growth of worst case is n. N means it is linear. Best case is 1. That is constant. Best case means array size is 100 also, only one time it is performed. Array size is 1 lakh also, it is performed only one time. Is that okay? This is best case and worst case. So now, what is the best? Best case RT means running time, LS means linear search, is big O of n. Is this correct or not? RT means running time, LS means linear search. Best case running time of linear search is big O of n. Is this true or false? Best case, what is the order of growth?
1, sir.
In the best case, order of growth is 1. 1 means that is n power 0. best case running term of, that means actually what is that we are saying here, n power 0 is big O of n or not, we are asking, that's all, no? If this true or not, we are asking, that's all. Is it true or not? N power 0 is big O of n. Is it true or false? N power 0 is big O of n. Is it true or false? It is true only, no?
Yes.
This should be less than, the n means n power 1, no? N means n power 1. N power 0 is less than or equal to n power 1, no?
Yes, sir.
Are you getting on?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Is it true or not? This is true. So, best case running time of linear search is big O of n. Is it true or not? True. Big O of 1. Is it true or not? Again, this is same. Best case running time of linear search is big O of 1. Is it true or not?
True, sir.
True. Big O of n power 100. Is this true or not? Is that true or not?
True, sir.
True. True. But out of this, which is your favorite answer?
Order of 1, sir.
1.
This is your favorite answer. Now we say that best case running time of linear search is big O of 1. Now I'll write like this. Best case running time, BC means best case running time of linear search. Same thing I am repeating. Is big omega of 1. Is this true?
True, sir. True, sir.
Big omega of 1 by n. Is this true? That's what one participant asked, doubt, no, n power minus 1, negative values and all. Is this true or not? This value becomes 0 actually. This is n power 0. At least this is smaller than this, no. This is also true. But out of these two, which is our favorite?
Omega 1.
Why? Because more value is our favorite. Next. Best case running time of linear search is, one second, madam is calling, one second. Hello madam. Hello madam. Hello. Oh, okay, madam. Okay, thank you, madam. I'll close it, madam. Okay, thank you. Okay. So, best case running time of linear search is theta of 1. Out of this is also correct, this is also correct. This is also correct. So this is the way of doing it. Now if it is recursive algorithm, then what is that we need to do? If it is a recursive algorithm, because I have to close it within 5 minutes, I just show you this. If it is a recursive algorithm, same procedure we follow, only difference is we will get a recurrence relation. A sequence is called recurrence relation. This is a sequence, nth term we represent in terms of its previous terms with the initial conditions, that we call it as a recurrence relation. For example, this is a recurrence relation with initial condition this. Okay, no. And these are different examples for recurrence relations, linear recurrence, homogeneous. These are different ways of solving recurrence relations. Okay, now this is an algorithm. How to solve this? How to find the order of growth of running time of this algorithm? Your basic operation, the input size is n. This is multiplication operation. Number of times this operation is performed. If n is input, tn minus 1 times it is performed. But one operation extra here. So that's why t of n minus 1 plus 1. If n equal 1, only 0 times it is performed. But here it is 1. Here printing mistake. Here it is 1. Now if you solve this recurrence relation, we will get order of growth as n. So that is the way. Only everything is same. Only fourth step we will get that recurrence relation we get. There we will get summation expression. So here, this is the way to solve. This is called substitution method. By substitution method, you can solve it and you will get n. So now there was often a standard problem. All of you must be knowing. Here, this I am not skipping due to I'm skipping due to this. And here, basic operation is n. Input size is n. This is our moving a disk from one side to another side. Here, this is the reconciliation we get. And this is the substitution method. By using substitution method, we can solve it. By solving this, we get 2 power n minus 1. That means it is exponential. Similarly, Fibonacci sequence, this is nth term in the Fibonacci sequence. So this is algorithm. This addition is this. So this is the thing. If you solve it, you will get exponential. This is the way. For this, you should know how to solve reconciliations and all. So for that, for that we have, so these are different characteristic root method. In this characteristic root method, we should write a characteristic equation, then we need to find a general solution. This is the way we do it. This I am not doing to this. And this is the way of finding this. For this, we should know reconciliations in detail. Reconciliations in detail. Now, see, finally, in this, this what is that I have done is, I have told you what are different asymptotic notations, 5 asymptotic notations, how to analyze time complexity of different recurrence, non-recursive algorithms. Next, what is the difference between best case running time and worst case running time? What introduction to reconciliations that I am not fully done. Next, general plan for analyzing complexity of recursive algorithms. That's what I have done. And these are the references. This is a very good book for algorithms topic. And algorithms, but entry level, it is very difficult because this is very easy. Sorry, this is very easy. Usually you can understand this. Asymptotic, some parts I have taken from this, some parts I have taken from this. And this is for actually reconciliation part. This is the reference. Thank you. Sorry for extending this. Okay, no, because I thought of covering some topics, some additional things. Thank you very much. If you have any questions, you can ask. Thank you. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Thank you,
sir.
Thank you so much, sir. Rani ma'am, shall
yes,
I proceed
yes.
ma'am?
Yes,
sir, I think this is since this is an interactive session, there is no queries in participant sides.
Okay.
Side by side, you have cleared all the doubts, sir. Thank you so much, sir.
Okay.
So the participants are very clear with the content you have delivered and there is no queries to clarify. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you very much, ma'am. Thank you. Bye, ma'am.
Okay. Rani ma'am?
Sudha ma'am?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah, now you continue.
Good afternoon to all. Now I shall deliver the vote of thanks. First and foremost, I express my sincere thanks to our resource person, Dr. Venkata Subbareddy, for having readily accepted our invitation for this webinar. Thank you, sir, for the tremendous efforts you have taken to enhance our knowledge on recurrence relations and analysis of algorithms. I also thank all the participants for showing their keen interest in participating in this national webinar and sharing their queries. I sincerely thank our management, our correspondent sir, principal ma'am, and vice principal ma'ams for their constant support and motivation to organize this event. Thank you, one and all.
Thank you, sir.
Okay, thank you very much.
Shall we end the meeting, sir?
Oh, okay, madam. I just okay, log out. Leave.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, now you are stop your share screen, sir. Sudha ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Shall we close the end the meeting, ma'am?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Silva.
Okay. Yes, ma'am.
Okay.